So the other job I've done the other day was just a video to show a strip down service on an Ideal Logic. I think it was a heat only. It's just to show basically that how easy the logics are to work on. You can see how little tools you need to actually strip it. I think it was less than 2 minutes. I'm trying to get a timer on the video so you can see how quick that was. So less than 2 minutes to strip a boiler, so you can actually service it as per the instructions. Get some water down a heat exchange, giving that a good flush out. I carry a little watering can that I use just for pouring the water through the heat exchanger. So yeah, really, there's no excuse on a Logic to not be stripping them. The burner seals, not a problem. I've never had one split on me. I do carry them just in case, but I've never had one go taking the burner out. So there's no reason not to strip that burner down and wash it through. It takes 2 minutes. So here's the video of that. To do any job like this, you must be gas safe registered. You cannot take the front off that boiler unless you've got a gas safe registration. So yeah, any questions? Put them below, and thanks, guys.
So these are the three tools I'll be using to complete strip this boiler for service. So two screws underneath with a screwdriver allows you to remove the front cover, drop the front fascia down, and remove the sump cover plate. Remove the flue to sump turret, and then an 8mm socket or spanner to remove the fan retaining bolt. This bolt can be left in place and the fan be removed, however I find it easier to just simply remove the bolt altogether. And the fan lift up and away, disconnect the clip from the gas valve. Remove the electrics, that's the fan removed. Now it's simply a case of removing the burner, which is 4 8mm bolts, two at the front and two at the back. This back right hand nut is the most awkward as it sits behind the top flue turret. Once loose, you can normally just undo it with the tips of your fingers. Depending how big your hands are, I've got big shovel hands, so I have to ram them in there and get the bolt off. And then once that bolt is removed, you can then lift the burner. Just slide simply towards you, and that's it, all done. And then if you put the sump cover plate back on, you can then pour water down through the heat exchanger. You'll see the little watering can I carry here, it's perfect for this job. Pour as much as you want down through the heat exchanger. I generally find this is enough to clean the condensate trap. Obviously if there's any big lumps of debris, I'll remove the trap and clean it through itself. But this normally does the job just enough.